more music. I can ain't jalooted.com.
Going to bring solution to the question you've just viewed just now. We're going to solve this question on capital allowance. So I hope you have copied the question. You've taken care of everything in the question. We're going to resolve the question biblically. So I want you to prepare your mind. Make sure you have your calculator so that we can work on this. Is a question in capital allowance. The question says that Abaco PLC made a purchase of the following assets, and we have in June 15, 1995, he purchased plant and machineries at 30,000. Then in January 10th of 96, he purchased a motor vehicle, 50,000. Then on December 1996, they also purchased equipment of 82,000, and we as well given the rate of allowances to be plant and machinery. We have initial allowance and annual allowances. The rates are given, and the question said we should prepare a schedule which will show how the capital allowances are being calculated. So we are going to solve this question right now. Let's start immediately to resolve the question. Make sure you have your calculator. It's very important that your calculator is around you. So it's good you put up the name of the company first. We have Abaco PLC. Abaco PLC. Computation of capital allowance. So I'm having three columns here because if you look at the question, you verify that there are three different types of assets given in this question. In this question, we have plants and machineries. So we have plants here. And we have, they still bought motor vehicles, put it up here. And they still purchased equipment. You have equipment here. So one more column is needed for capital allowance. Let me just put the one more column here. So this one will be capital allowance, which is what we are about to compute. Then we can now have the details here. We'll have the details. Then we'll talk about the years involved. So with this presentation now, we shall now start working into solving the question. The question says we should compute this for 1995, 1996, 1997, and 1998. So your computation should start from 1995. So what you do is to assemble all the assets they purchased on this date. All the assets purchased on this date. If you look at the question, you verify that in 95, we have only one asset that we have purchased, and that is plant and machinery, and there's no other plant and machinery in this question. So we just put up costs. You come here and write cost. Under the cost, you put the value of the asset they purchased, which is 30,000. So the plant was purchased for 30,000. We have 30,000 here. Under the cost, there's no new motor vehicle purchased and no equipment was purchased. So we just put dash, dash, and dash. Then, after this, what we should do now is to calculate for initial allowance. Initial allowance. I told you earlier in video clip A that initial allowance is calculated once throughout the useful life of an asset. So initial allowance is given to us as the rate is given in this question paper, and the rate for initial allowance for plant is 10%. So what we do is you do 10% of 30,000. 10% times 30,000. We'll close up. So when you do 10% of 30,000, it will be giving us 3,000. We'll have 3,000 here. You bracket it. And when you bracket it, you come to this under the capital allowance and still put the 3,000. But don't bracket this one. Then this place are dash, dash, since there's no other asset purchased in 1995. Then another thing you have to calculate here is annual allowance. Annual allowance. Annual allowance is granted yearly throughout the useful life of the asset. So how do we calculate this now? We give a formula to for calculation of annual allowance. We say the formula is we give a formula for annual allowance to be C minus initial allowance minus 10 or multiplied by the rate of annual allowance. And in this question, our cost is 30,000 minus initial allowance we got now is 3,000, then minus 10 or multiplied by rate of annual allowance. And the rate of annual allowance for, and this analysis is for plants, the rate of annual allowance here is 10%. So we use our calculator to get this out immediately. So we're going to do 30,000. I'm pressing calculator right now. 30,000 minus 3,000 minus 10. We have 26,990. Then you times it by 10%. What we have here is the rate is 10%. So when you times it by 10%, we'll be having 26,990. So this is what you have as the annual allowance of plants, and this annual allowance should be on straight line throughout. So as we've gotten this figure, we are not going to compute any other allowance for any other annual allowance for plants. This figure will continue until the asset is fully consumed. So we're going to put up this value now under the annual allowance, then close up the account of 1995 so that we can go into the account of 1996. So what we have is 26,990. They still bracket it again. Of course, we have shown the calculation already here, but let me just see, show 30,000 minus 3,000 initial allowance minus 10 or times rate of annual allowance, which is 10%. So that gave this value. So we now have a dash here, and we have dash here. Then the same figure will come up here again, 26,990. So at this point, we'll close up the account of 1995. We'll overrule. Then we'll overrule again. So what we do now is we now have the written down value WDV at end of 1995. The written down value at the end of 1995. So we now use our calculator and then try to get these figures down. So let's press our calculator. 30,000 minus 3,000 minus 2699. We have a figure here, which is 24301. So we have dash dash, then we'll add up the two values of the capital allowance. So this becomes 5,699. So what it means is that the capital allowance in 1995 is 5,699. Now this is going to take us to 1996, which is the next year. We now say written down value or net book value brought forward. So we are bringing forward this amount, 24301. You don't bring forward the capital allowance, this one is over for this, so you don't bring it down again. Written down value brought forward, so we'll be having a dash dash, and you don't have anything here. Then you're not talking about cost, so it seems we are trying to repeat the whole process again. You start with cost again. What are the new assets purchased in 1996? Did they buy a new motor vehicle? If they purchased a new motor vehicle, you put it under the motor vehicle. But since the question is telling us that they did not purchase a new motor vehicle, what we should do is to put dash here. Then you check whether they bought the second asset, which is yes, they purchased a new motor vehicle. A motor vehicle was bought on 10th of January, amounting to 50,000. So we should be having 50,000 here. 50,000. Then if you check very well, you still verify that in the same 1996, on March 18th, they still bought an equipment worth 82,000. So we'll be having 82,000 here too. 82,000. So this place runs down to dash. That means that we are going to calculate initial allowance for motor vehicle, and we'll calculate initial allowance for equipment. Then after that, we'll still calculate annual allowance for motor vehicle and annual allowance for equipment. Why the annual allowance of plant will still go? So we're going to do double calculations right now. So let's go to our worksheet and work out the initial allowance of motor vehicle. Now for motor vehicle, for motor vehicles, now we have a initial allowance for motor vehicle, and that should be, this motor vehicle was purchased for 50,000. So we have 50,000 multiplied by the rate of initial allowance in the question is 15%. So we'll do 15%. So we'll now do 50,000 times 15%. 15% is 15 over 100, which is 0.15 times 50,000. And we're having 7,500. So this is initial allowance for motor vehicle. We're going to do the same thing for equipment. So have equipment too. Equipment initial allowance will be giving us, the equipment was purchased for 82,000 multiplied by the rate of initial allowance for equipment is 10%. So we'll be having 10% here. 10%. And 10% of 82,000 will give us 8,200. So these figures will come in here as a initial allowance. So this person is going to be dashed because we have already computed the initial allowance for motor vehicle, because it's charged only once throughout the useful life of the asset. So the initial allowance for motor vehicle is coming up here to be 7,500, and this man will be coming to be 8,200. Then you bracket two of them. You bracket this and this, then add two of them up and bring it under the capital allowance. So let's carry out this right now. From calculator, we have 7,500 plus 8,200, and that will give us 15,700. So we'll put 15,700 here, 15,700. then this will now take us to annual allowance of the two assets. Annual allowance of two of them again. So this one is initial allowance. Let's do the annual allowance now. We're going to do for motor vehicles. Annual allowance for motor vehicle, which is a cost. Cost is 50,000. Minus initial allowance is 7,500 minus 10. Everything we have here should be times the rate of annual allowance for motor vehicle. The rate of annual allowance for motor vehicle, as stipulated in the question, is 20%. So we'll be having 20% here. 20%. And this will give us from calculator. Okay, let's put up this. We'll have equipment too under annual allowance. Equipment is, the cost of equipment is 82,000 minus the initial allowance. Minus initial allowance is 8,200. Then minus 10 again, then times how many percent are we having here? For annual allowance on the equipment is 20%. So we say times 20% again. Two of them are having 20%. So let's try to use calculator to work out this value right now. So we're having 50,000 minus 7,500 minus 10 equal to then times 0.2, which is 20%. And that will give us 8,498. So we're having 8,498 here. Then we'll come to equipment. We have 82,000 minus 8,200 minus 10. And we have 73,790 times 0.2. We're having 14,758. 14,758. So this is the annual allowance we have for motor vehicles and equipment. So what we're going to do now is we're going to carry this figure inside the solution immediately. Now annual allowance for the first asset here is plant and machineries. Is 2,699. So that figure will still come up again. 2,699. We'll bracket it. Then that of motor vehicle. Motor vehicle is 8,498. We have 8,498. We'll still bracket it. And we'll come for the next asset is so we'll have 14,758 here, which is the annual allowance for equipment. So we'll add up the three of them. We'll add 2,699 plus to get the capital allowance for 1996. 2,699 plus 8,498 plus 14,758. And this will be giving us 25,955. 25,955. So this is the total capital allowance under annual allowance. Then we just have to over. So we'll come to 1997. 1997, we start with the same process. We have costs. In 1997, there was no other asset purchased in 97. So you just put dash. Now talk about initial allowance. Since there's no new asset purchased, there will be no initial allowance. So we have dash. They talk about annual allowance. Annual allowance is chargeable annually. So we're going to, all of them have annual allowance. We bring them forward on straight line basis. The same figure we charge from 95 is what we are charging all through. So we're having 2,699. 2,699. They will have 498. They will have a 14758. We'll bracket all of them and then add it up. That is the capital allowance for under annual allowance. So from calculator, we'll be having 2699 plus 8498 plus 14758, and this will give us 25955. So we have 25955. Then we overrule. We overrule. They will now say written down value at end again. So how do we get this figure now? This is the written down value at the end of 1996. We're going to minus this to get the one of the end. Actually, this figure is supposed to be here at the beginning, but it's still giving you the same value. So we're having 21602 minus 2699. This will give us 18903. That will do 34002 minus 8498. That will give us 25504. We have 25504. Then 59042 minus 14758. That will give us 44284. We have 44284. So that is what we're having here. Then nothing for this. Then we overrule. You now say 1998 written down value. Brought forward, we bring down these figures 18903, we have 25504, we have 44284. Then we have dash here, initial allowance, we have dash. Then annual allowance, the same figure remains the annual allowance, we have 2699, then 8498. You have 14758. So we'll close up. The bracket means we are subtracting. We'll close up. So we'll add up right now. So we'll add this. We have 2699 plus 8498 plus 14758. So we're having 25955. 25955. So this is the total capital allowance for 1998. Then we overrule again. Then we overrule again to get the written down value. This almost getting to our answer. Then we subtract. 18903 minus 2699. We now have 21602. Then we now have again 25504 minus 8498. We're having 17006. 17006. Then we have 44284 minus 14758. This will be giving us 295526. Then we have this total here 25955. So this becomes the written down value at end of 1998. So this is the end of this question, because they say we should compute this question for 95, 96, 97 and 98, which means 4 years starting from 1995. So what we'll be having here is the capital allowances has been calculated. So these are the capital allowance. This one is this is a capital allowance. These are the figures that are needed. This capital allowance, and this one is still needed 2,5,2,5,9,5,5. So we can equally bring it here 2,5,9,5,5. So this one is still needed together with the other two. So this is just steps by which you can take to calculate capital allowance whenever you see a kind of a question that resemble what we just solved. So watch out for a video clip C in the same capital allowance, because the journey is still beginning.
Oh, can you see that, man? I don't talk, I don't get time to wait.